Hello, you awesome people. How the heck are you? If you enjoyed the video that you're about to watch, give it a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Behind me, you can see that's the remnants of one of the cardinals that made a nest in the yard and didn't turn out so well. Nature is a beast. Thought I'd give you a little update on the hummingbird that I got. It's exhausting doing stuff like this. I mean, I stay up to about 1:30 in the morning, and I wake up at 6:30 in the morning to go to work. But I like to stay up early in the morning to keep feeding it and make sure it doesn't starve. It has problems walking. It hasn't even tried to fly yet. And what I did, because it needs something else to sustain itself other than sugar water, I bought some fruit flies. And, well, just watch the video and see what happens. I'm going to go inside and relax. But life is good. Peace. Oh, ain't you a hot mess for a bird? All right, so what I've done is on the, somebody had suggested, of course, the bird cannot live by just sugar water. It needs protein. And I procured some fruit flies at PetSmart. And we tried these out. And the fruit flies successfully crawled all over our little bird there, and the bird did not care about eating them. So now the dilemma is, how do you get the fruit flies to the bird, inside the bird? And I came up with the idea of, along with the sugar water mix, oh my goodness, okay, hold on, you're voracious, all right. What I did is I took the fruit flies and just kind of made a fruit fly puree in the sugar water mixture, hoping that enough of the protein and the insides of the insects will get into the belly of the little beast. And it acts like it's starving. I don't know. I guess it's just that the hummingbirds have a high metabolism, whatever. But this is, you know, I have to feed it just all the time. So here's the sugar water and fruit fly guts mixture. There you go. I'll just put it down there. Oh, sorry, you want it closer, my bad. So hopefully the little bits of the fruit flies will get inside of him, and he'll get some, I guess it would be the protein from the insects. Is that it? And that's just straight sugar water. No, don't add any red dye. I don't know why people will add the red dye to their bird hummingbird feeder mixture. But as you can see, it's a lot better off. When I first found it, I swear to God, I thought it was going to die, but It's doing a hell of a whole lot better. It still has problems walking. And, it? Okay. Hasn't tried to fly at all. And I all. don't drink that, Jeff. That wasn't your rum and coke. That was the bird's food. There you go. But it'll, eats like a pig. It'll get really active after, of course, it sucks down the sugar water. And it's an inquisitive, it's an inquisitive little bird. There we go. The bird poop. It's a good animal. I mean, it's come a long way so far. I really need to put it under some warm water really carefully. Her feathers are matted. Some of the sugar water gets on the feathers, and I'm going to wash that off. But still, all in all, I think she's doing well. And hopefully the little... little mixture. Just to show you. That's dinner, buddy. And she likes it a lot. Or he likes it a lot. So I believe I could probably keep this in the refrigerator and cover it up. I don't want it to spoil. Maybe keep it for a day. I'll slightly warm it up. Because I don't want her just to have regular sugar water. I want her to have something, some real meat and potatoes. You done, girl? Or guy? All right, that's it. That's all she wrote. All right, be another 15 minutes. She'll be wanting to eat again. Y'all have a good evening. And, I think that's something. All right, y'all tighten up. Peace.